Have here this man D-202 mega bus. So it does have a sort of a switch for mega bus, but to be honest, it doesn't really do that much. It kind of starts distorting the sound. Maybe it's improving a little bit the audio, but it does have a nice audio level indicator here. Quite cool, quite cool. There's line out on the sides, and there's the volume switch, volume knob. I have to say, I didn't find it's too loud. It's kind of missing power in my opinion, but perhaps also it's because you need to use this old jack standards. Even this one has three pieces. I'm not sure if it's really the best one. Perhaps one with two pieces, it's better. But the modern one have even four segments, and that's not very good. It doesn't like it. It's an old jack 3.5, but it's not up to the today's standards. It doesn't read MP3s. It's skipping a lot. It doesn't have anti-skip memory to it. Old unit. It does have modes, playback modes, and I believe one of the modes allows you to put the tracks in order, RMS. I'll put the instruction manual in the comment section. Shuffle. Now be aware, these old units usually have a hold button. What hold button does is that when you switch it to on, it will prevent you from activating anything here. Now it's off, but if I switch it on and if I try pressing anything, it's not going to work. And it's good to know, perhaps, because if by chance you have it to on and the unit it's off, it will actually not even turn on. So let's just stop it. I'm turning the unit off right now. One more. Okay, and then if the hold button is to on, if you touch the buttons, it's not going to react, and you may be thinking, hey, the battery is gone or it's just dead altogether. But that's not true. It's just this hold button. It was intentionally was to prevent you from touching buttons while carrying the unit. But yep. Also, you have this open here. Let's just try it. It has another button. I'm not sure what it does in this one. So that's how you open the lid here. And usually you're just grabbing the CD like this gently and careful not to touch the lenses here. So it's a basic unit, nothing fancy inside. Clamp it down, close, and you're good to go. I guess one day this is going to be so retro, it's going to look like a unit coming from another era, and people will not even know how to activate it and how to play it back. Yep, you also have the Sony sticker. It says it's a Sony. All right.